I'm back. I mean, I'm not really back. I'm half back. You guys have been asking for a tutorial. I made one with Christine and I got, you know, a little taste of it when I did an Instagram post yesterday, because this is actually getting filmed and posted today just because I'm fucking feeling it. And I was like going through my thing and everyone's like, I smell a video tutorial. Can we see a video tutorial? We missed the tutorials. I was like, okay, let's do it. But I figured instead of doing that exact same one, I'll do like a heavier makeup that I do when I model for my store, the opposite end of the spectrum for me. So that's like my like light everyday whatever makeup, and this is gonna be my potentially scary in real life. We'll see. I have to work an entire day in the store before I go to the studio tonight to take photos, but this is gonna be the makeup that I wear when I model, which is best represented by this photo that I'll splice in right here. That was like my favorite. I mean, my hair was really great in that, and I had like done a bunch of pink tinge in my hair, so that's why it was looking so great. But the makeup was good too. So I'm gonna do that makeup look, and I already fucked up because I forgot my beauty blender, and that's kind of important. And Sephora doesn't open for another half an hour, but that's also when my store opens, so not happening. So I'm just gonna have to apply it with my hands, which I don't know if I'll be able to do well, so I'm just like, eee! Okay. So, do you like my sweater? It's from Rachel Antonoff. It's located, how do I do this? I'm like a weather person. Right here in my store and online, shopanomi.com. But I'm obsessed with it. This is the extra small. It's so cute. It also comes in maroon. Plug, 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 plug. Okay, so we're doing this. Makeup tutorial 2K17. First one of the year, I think. And like any face, I start off with Sunday Riley Good Jeans, the big bottle, cause I'm bloop, rich bitch, bought it in a sale. Space NK sale right around my birthday. Thank you very much. So I did baby facial last night, so I don't know, maybe I shouldn't put this on. Maybe my skin's too sensitive, but I just wear it every single day. I also really hope that you guys see like somebody come up to the window and like look in the store and they're like, what's this girl doing? It's actually a bad idea to film it this way because the file is just gonna like be really big because there's gonna be constant movement behind me. Okay, so Good Jeans on, and then we go Glossier Priming Moisturizer. I feel so artistic when I do that, like when I just, like I don't know, it's like an artist with like a painter's palette. So, the key to any makeup look is a moisturized face, and I really love moisturizing. This one's nice, it's nice and light, simple. Nothing much going on with it, and it doesn't have SPF, which is crucial because I do flash for the photography. So as I said in my Instagram post yesterday, redness correction is my main makeup concern. So I'm using this. Someone recommended me one in the comments. I'm down for any and all recommendations on great green color correcting primers, because really, that's a big issue. I miss this, talking to my non-existent friends that exist, but just like not here. I think this is like peak life for me, this amount of social interaction. I am not alone, but I'm alone. Zen. Okay, so I've got that on, and now I go for, I think these are absolutely beautiful foundations. I love them in photographs. I don't wear them all the time just because I think they're just like a little cakey for day-to-day life. I mean, it always just looks so good. It's just like a lot to do, you know? I can't, so that's why I go skin tint or powder for the day-to-day. But these are the YouTube OG Silk Cream Foundations from Laura Mercier. And depending on the season, whatever, with my skin, Rose Ivory, Soft Ivory mix, or just Soft Ivory. So I think I'm gonna do Soft Ivory mainly, and the tiniest bit of the rose ivory, because the rose ivory is like pink, pure pink. And less is more with this, with the Beauty Blender. Shit, I haven't done this with my hands in a while, so please excuse me. So I did that much, and I may need more. And then I did that much. Can you tell the difference between the two? Yeah, big color difference. One's super yellow, one's really dark. Okay, mixing them together. Oh, I'm nervous with my hands. If only I had like what, a ball sack? What are the fucking, what are you guys doing on YouTube these days? I walk away for a while and then people are using their, or maybe that's Instagram, people are using ball sacks to put on makeup. This is insanity. And chicken and these silicone thingies. Oh my god, this is not good without a Beauty Blender. Okay, ignore all this. Do I hate it? I'm getting kind of warm. Can I take my sweater off? It's hot in here. Okay, so next up is gonna be concealer and Glossier Stretch Concealer. This one's a good coverage concealer for me. The one that I really love that is from, I think L'Oreal, I don't know what it's called. It's nice, but it doesn't truly cancel out like what's going on underneath my eyes. So truly this one is my preferred concealer for under eyes when I'm shooting. I like things to be a little bit darker than my usual skin tone when I am doing my e-commerce photo shoots, because the flash tends to wash me out and I turn the brightness up and all that kind of stuff. So my skin tone becomes a little bit irrelevant. I tend not to really conceal my chin if there's nothing that's too dramatic. Again, because it's photography, I can, if there's a bad blemish or something, instead of really struggling to conceal it and like clogging it up with makeup and stuff for the day, I can just use a little spot tool and get rid of it. So spot tool is your friend if you're having a chin breakout and you are the reluctant model for your own store. Just, you know, from me to you. My next item, again, YouTube favorite, the best powder contour in the world for a pale person, Kevin Aucoin Sculpting Powder in, I guess it's light. There's nothing on the back. But I think I remember buying medium one time and being like, what the hell? They changed the formula because I didn't think there was multiple colors. And the store I bought it from like only carried medium, which was weird. So I use a MAC 168 brush, 168 or 163. All of my 8s and my 3s have worn off of my MAC brushes, so I can't tell. But this I go heavy with. For this brush, I squeeze it a little, like when I use it, to make it a little bit more straight and tapered. It's hard to get the angle. A lot of my contour gets lost in the flash or lost in the brightness uptick that I do when I edit the photo. So really, you gotta have a lot. Plus, I mean, who doesn't love a lot? Just anyways, for fun. So I use the same brush and I just get some of my really disgusting NARS Madly, and as little as possible, because this stuff goes a long way. I do up my cheeks pretty aggressively. Lately I've been getting like redness things like right here. It's not really like high enough to like get hit with my eye concealer. But if I put any concealer there, when I put on blush, it just ends up making it go away. So I've noticed that, like some red spots and stuff, which I don't know what that's about. So next up is highlighter, which I tried to clean it so that I could take like a good photo of it. So like this was the side that I was like, oh, this will show. But this is what the whole thing looked like. This thing just like picks up like nastiness and you can kind of like scrape it off, but it's just bad. So I pop about that much. And then I'll bring this highlighter with me when I go to the studio. I'll bring the highlighter and the wowder that I'm gonna show you. And those are the things that I actually reapply like as I'm shooting for certain things where it's just like, ooh, this needs more highlighter. And then, ooh, I need more powder, I'm too shiny. So, I just need it a little bit more. And then I gotta go down the nose. I also forgot my eye primer, so I don't know, shouldn't your face primer be able to double as an eye primer? Primer. And actually this is like the reddest part of my face is my eyelids. Okay, so from the look that I showed you guys, I was having a real moment with pink eyeshadow, particularly the pink eyeshadow from the Naked 3 palette, and that was Buzz right here, this pink one. So I'm gonna do Buzz in my typical all over the eye, blend it out underneath the eye, pair it with an eyeliner in the bottom waterline eye look. And I clean my brushes for you and everything. Can you tell I was excited? Little brush for underneath the eye. And bigger brush to blend out. Believe it or not, this eye look goes with a lot because one of the things I have to think about when I'm setting up my makeup and stuff for these photo shoots and why I typically never wear lipstick in them is because you have to have something that's gonna work with like a lot of different clothes and a lot of different colors of clothes because I tend to do a gigantic shoot. Like I'll shoot probably like 3 or 4 different brands and probably like 10 to 20 pieces, and so that's a lot of different looks that you have to do. So I just want something that's like universal, and for me I found just what looks really nice on me is like an interesting colored eyeshadow. It took me, or just to do no eyeshadow at all and just kind of like a blank face, but that looked a little bit better when my hair was like a different color, so that was kind of the thing. But like there was a time when I had to do a shoot, but for like really like fall neutrally colored clothes, but it was around the time that I was dyeing my hair pink and like wearing my pink eyeshadow, and it just didn't like work out together, but it's like my hair was pink, like there was nothing I could do about it, and like, you know, low budge, I'm the model for the store. So that's always my apprehension with like the fun colors and stuff I wanna do for my hair is like, oh, will that work well for the season? So we'll see. I'm trying to work my way up to dyeing my hair like legit orange and just like being a redhead for a little bit because that goes with like everything. It really does. People who think that it doesn't, it does. I try to tell my mom that all the time. It goes with everything. Originally, when I first started doing the shoots for my store, I wouldn't put something in the bottom waterline because I normally wore silver. And I found that the silver like reflected or it made my eyes just look a little strange. But then I discovered that a color and one that's not gonna like reflect and get washed out makes it much better. So this is a Marc Jacobs highlighter in Popular, which I have actually yet to wear, but I figured pink and pink, it's gonna look good. That's fun. It just, like, colored eyeliner completes the look. I can't stress this enough. Why aren't you doing it yet? If you are, good job. And if you aren't, go get some. It's fun. Just do it. And the key for e-commerce makeup, the key with the flash photography and the lights on you and it being sweaty because it's in the summer and you're in a non-air conditioned room, is to not be shiny, because I'm not really that good at Photoshop. I don't know how to get rid of shine. I can get rid of a zit and I can like change the brightness and that's about it. So Wouter is now my new BFF for, I have it with me in the studio, like carried around with me when I go there. But this is the shade light medium, which I wish there was a light shade because that would be me, but I kind of just grab it actually from the lid and try to mix it. That's my one qualm with the packaging, is like I wish you had that lid situation, like how you kind of have with every powder, that you can go in and do that. So this is just very important for me to be able to get rid of any potential shininess here and like right in there, because it can just ruin a photo. This brush is very soft, by the way, and it's very pretty. Okay, so I avoid the places that I highlighted, but and then the chin too. And then honestly, I like powder on my neck more than I like foundation to be on my neck, so I powder the neck. Like now I feel like you can't see any, like you can kind of catch some dewiness like on here, but like you're not gonna catch it on my forehead. So that gets reapplied a couple times throughout the shoot. They last like, oh my God, how long? My longest time I ever did it was like 8 hours. That was so much stuff to shoot. Oh, it's so tiring too. People don't give models enough credit. It's tiring. You have to stand there so much. A lot of my feet kill me by the end of it, and I'm wearing heels and all this, so it's hard work. Before I do my mascara, I do my brows. Fuck my life. I forgot my eyebrow pencil. I forgot my eyebrow thing. I'm angry, but you can't tell because my eyebrows aren't drawn on yet. Oh no. This is a disaster. Fuck, what do I do? This is the tiniest thing I have. I bet I could use this. This tutorial is, don't do what I'm doing. This is, oh God, help me. Help me. It's like, again, I could go to Sephora, but, oh shit. I'm supposed to open in like 1 minute. Please, nobody try to come in here. I'm not done yet. Too much talking. Okay, this is, we'll see about this. Watch, this ends up being like the best way I've ever applied. It's not too bad so far. Honestly, not so bad. This is actually easier to do than my other brush. Well, learn new things every day. I can hear people behind me asking if the store is open. It's supposed to be open right now. Please walk away. Please walk away. Okay, good, they're gone. Okay, so now that was actually really easy, really great. Honestly, it looks better than what I did with that other fucking brush, so blessing in disguise. This is crazy. And always gotta put the Glossier Boy Brow on. And my Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir. I'm at the very end of this tube. I want more highlighter. So this is a makeup look that I would do for shooting photography for my store. It's a little fun, kind of simple. It's gonna go with a lot of shit, and I'm quite pleased with my freaking brows. I need to put this sweater back on. Get the full effect. You know, you gotta have the uterus sweater on for the finals, the final shot. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to wear this today. It was freezing cold yesterday and I wore a tank top, and then today I wear a sweater and it's hot. I don't understand San Francisco. Ugh. Okay, so I thought the pink would be cute to do with the green, because I'm also wearing these pink shoes today. So, yeah. I love it. It looks so much better with the contrast of the green too. So this is the makeup that I would wear if I was shooting e-commerce. It's also makeup I could wear out and makeup I can wear in the daytime. There's not really that much difference to a normal makeup look, but just for me, the daily one was kind of what I posted on my Instagram, and then I kind of wanted to show the juxtaposition because I never really go full contour crazy heavy. I mean, yeah, there's like wedding makeup with false eyelashes and shit, but I would absolutely never, never wear that to shoot for my store. It's just too much. So I like to keep it kind of simple, kind of fun, a little funky with the pink and whatnot. And look how long my hair is now. Yeah, anyways, so bye. Now I have to go open my store. So you need these and that, just saying. Okay, now bye. Oh, okay, also here's my outfit. Okay, now really bye.